It is exactly a year next week until voters in the United States head to the polls to elect the president. The race is shaping up as a repeat of 2020, Joe Biden and Donald Trump. But Trump's myriad legal issues and a potential spoiler by the name of Kennedy look set to complicate the equation in the coming months. A short time ago, I asked One News US correspondent Logan Church about the state of the race.
Well, at this stage, we're looking very much like we're going to see another Donald Trump and Joe Biden rematch. Joe Biden really pitching himself as a candidate focused on unifying the country, both domestically, where we have, just like New Zealand, a really quite terrible cost of living crisis, which is hurting many Americans, but also from a foreign policy perspective. He's deeply concerned about events happening in overseas, most recently in Israel as well. Donald Trump, though, is very much campaigning on the narrative of the American way of life is under attack. And in his words, he made America great again once, and he's the one that's needing to be back in power to do it all over again.
What role do you think Donald Trump's legal issues are going to play in the campaign?
Yeah, and that's one of the big question marks over what a potential another, I guess, Trump presidency might look like. He's facing a huge number of legal problems, dozens and dozens of charges, just for some of them. He's facing charges in relation to the January 6th insurrection in Washington, D.C. Right now, he's in the middle of a trial in New York City where he's been accused of committing business fraud. He's he's facing another trial down in Florida over allegedly keeping a huge stacks of secret documents at his Mar-a-Lago resort. He's also facing legal action over alleged attempts to overturn the 2020 election result in Georgia. Now, Donald Trump denies everything, and his message has very much been this is a political persecution by a Department of Justice that is filled with Joe Biden supporters. Now, that is a message that is resonating with his loyal followers. He's not the first political candidate who's faced legal woes to use that line, and he certainly will not be the last. The question, though, is whether he can convince the people in the middle, the people on the fence, whether he's right or not. And over the coming year or so, it's going to be really interesting to see how the chips fall in these many cases.
How do Americans feel about it, once again, being Donald Trump versus Joe Biden?
Look, pretty, I think, unenthused, to be completely honest with you. For example, a recent poll came out and it found that only about a third of Americans were either somewhat or very excited about a Donald Trump-Joe Biden rematch. However, at this stage, Jack, it looks like that's what essentially they're going to get. Many Americans are wondering whether there might be someone different or whether someone could be brought up through the ranks, but this election at this stage, saying there's still over a year to go, it does very much look like it's going to be a Biden v. Trump rematch.
Well, let's just consider the possibility of alternatives for a moment. So the Democrats are not running a primary campaign. They say that Joe Biden is their candidate. The Republicans, of course, are running a primary campaign. Is there any possibility that someone from within the GOP or from within the Dems could end up being their party's candidate?
Yeah, well, just to quickly cover off the Democrats, the short answer to that is, at this stage, no. The Democrats have very much fallen in line behind Joe Biden, the incumbent president. They're very supportive of him. Now, on the Republican side, it is a lot more interesting. Now, at this stage, Donald Trump is the clear front-runner. Among Republicans, he's polling around 47-48%. And the next group of people are far behind. But second place is currently Ron DeSantis, who's the governor of Florida. Now, he came into this race with a hiss and a roar, and I think it would be fair to say he probably hasn't capitalized on that as much as people were expecting him to. But the other rising star from the Republican side is Vivek Ramaswamy, who's a 38-year-old entrepreneur who made his money in the pharmaceutical business. His polling is going up very, very slowly, but there is certainly a bit of buzz and excitement around him. Whether, though, that comes anywhere near come next November next year, rather, when the Republicans have to select a candidate, whether that comes near to Donald Trump, well, who knows at this stage. But as it stands right now, Donald Trump is far in the lead there.
And there is a possibility of a third-party disruptor. Tell us about RFK Jr.
Yes, well, the Kennedys are back, or trying to get back at least. Robert Kennedy Jr. is the nephew of JFK, and a couple of weeks ago he announced that he would be making a run as an independent. Now, this is quite interesting because historically independents don't typically win presidential races. Well, they don't. There's just not a history of that happening. But there is certainly a question over where he may take votes from, and that's a really interesting question. Now, the people who are talking loudest about Robert Kennedy Jr. are actually the Republicans, indicating there might be some concern that he could take votes away from a candidate like Donald Trump, split that vote there, and potentially give the election next year to Joe Biden. So a lot of big question marks there. He's certainly a controversial candidate, though. He's a known anti-vaxxer, for lack of a better word. He's been against vaccines for a very long time. I'm not just talking about COVID. If you go back to the Samoan measles crisis in 2019, for example, he came out very strongly against the use of MMR vaccines. And he's been known to promote misinformation and disinformation around the safety of vaccines. So it's going to be really interesting as to where he may draw support from. But he is drawing support. On a recent poll, he was scoring around 13%, which is quite high for an independent candidate, especially when you consider that is about only a third of where both Donald Trump and Joe Biden were sitting in the same poll. So it's certainly someone that many people here are keeping a very close eye on.
That being said, under the US system, it's really hard to get on the ballot, right?
Yeah, so one of the big challenges for Robert Kennedy Jr. is he has to get onto the state ballots, and there's a lot of them. Now, if you are the nominee for the Republicans or the Democrats, you essentially get on automatically. That's not the case for an independent. He has to petition each state with thousands of signatures to get on the ballot. So that's a challenge there. And I think it's also worth mentioning that both the GOP and the Democrats, they are a big machines, not just a political machine, but also a fundraising machine. And they are institutions that have been here for a very, very long time. So it's an uphill battle for any independent candidate. So it's going to be interesting to see what he can achieve over the coming months.